Hi, it's Dina. I have a new set in my spring 2018 release called Layered Marble, and I wanted to give a little info about it and also show you how it can be used. There are three larger stamps in the set, and those are designed to layer together. And then there are three smaller stamps that can be used for accents or veining. Here's a digital representation of how the stamps can look together. And in this video, I just sat down to play with the stamps and see what different effects I could create with different inks. First, I wanted to try the Impression Obsession hybrid inks, since I love how they layer together. And they're also grouped into sets of light, medium, and dark, which makes color choice really easy. I used an acrylic block instead of a stamp positioner because I wasn't really concerned about perfection, and that actually worked fine for me. If you look at real marble, you'll see a lot of layering and depth in the grain and the veining of the stone, and you can achieve that look with the stamps even without lining them up perfectly, just by varying your inks. So I used the ink like I would with a regular layering stamp. I used the lightest ink with the boldest stamp, and then I used darker inks as I moved toward the most detailed image. And just that type of layering gave me the illusion of depth on my panel. And you can see here that I'm varying the way that I use the stamps each time too. Sometimes I've layered them pretty close together, and sometimes they're rotated or offset. Now I'm moving to the smaller accent stamps, and I'm going to use those to kind of connect the larger areas together. And again, these stamps aren't designed to layer together, but you can vary the inks again to create depth on your panel. So here's the finished panel. With this type of ink, you'll get a very clean look since the inks don't spread or blend together. So if that is a look that you prefer, I do recommend the hybrid inks. My next experiment was with Distress Oxide inks, and I thought I'd try stamping them and then misting my watercolor panel to get the ink to lift. But it didn't really work as well as I thought that it would, and I'm not sure why that was. It did work a little bit. And I really like the idea of the water moving the ink out from the stamped image because that's more of the look of actual marble. You know how the coloring is a little more fluid than the effect that I got in my first sample. So I did move the color a little with my brush and with a heat gun, and that helped a little bit. And as I worked, I noticed that the ink reacted a little better if the panel was already wet. So I started moving that way in my experimenting, and I liked that look a little better. So now we're getting somewhere. And when you get your stamp set, I hope that you'll take the time to just sit down and experiment with the inks that you have as well. That's really the best way to know what's going to work best for you. I moved on to the regular Distress ink, and this time I'm inking and then spritzing the stamp with water before I stamp it, and I really like this effect a lot better. Between applying layers of color, you might want to dry each layer with your heat gun. And the ink will lift a little, but you won't end up with a big muddy mess. You'll also see me spritzing the back side of the panel. When it gets wet on the front, it tends to bow up. And if you spritz on the back side, it'll even back out. As you're experimenting, you may want to vary how much water you use and experiment with that. I did one sample that had drip marks in it from too much water, and that sort of ruined the marble effect. Here I've added in some black oxide ink, and then I used a little bit of metallic ink for some shimmer on my panel. And this actually is my favorite sample, so I'll definitely be using this method again. In my last experiment here, I spritzed my watercolor panel with water first and then stamped with the oxide ink. And you can see how that really encourages the ink to spread. And this is probably what I should have been doing in the first place. I should mention that I'm using Fabriano Studio Hot Press paper. It's easy to buy in bulk, and it's one of my go-tos for card making. I smushed my panel into some of the water and ink that was on my craft mat, and that's another way to add texture to a panel like this. Then I grabbed a dye ink, and those are fun to experiment with too, because sometimes the component colors of the ink will separate out in water. And that can add some interesting effects. For the veining and the finer layers, I used less water so the details would be more distinct. And I may have done a little bit too much on this panel, but that's okay. Every piece of marble is different, and that is the fun of a set like this. This set is a lot of fun to play with, and I hope you'll give it a try. You can find all my stamp designs at iostamps.com under Dina Kowal Creative. Thanks for watching.